Hi guys, welcome to Gold Mac. Today I'm going to go through and show you how you can work out the weight of your gold specimens without destroying them. The only accurate way to do it is you've got to crush them down in a little dolly pot and pan it out and then weigh up the gold. But if you want to be able to leave it in your specimen and just get yourself a pretty good estimation, I'll go through with how we work that out. What you'll need is your gold specimen, you'll need a pair of scales, you'll need a little container to be able to keep your water in, and also you'll just need a little bit of cotton or string, some light material to be able to wrap around your specimen and suspend in the water. So the main thing is that your water vessel has to be large enough to be able to suspend your gold specimen in it without it actually touching the sides or the bottom of the container. Okay, so the first step that you need to do to work out this weight of your specimen, you need to work out its specific gravity. And the way that you work out something's specific gravity is that you weigh it in air or dry. So if we were to chuck it on the scales here now and weigh that up, see that comes to 3.66. So that's what I've already taken these measurements, but you take your dry measurement and you put your little water vessel on your scales and you tear that down to zero, so it's not registering anything. And now I'm going to slip this little bit of cotton just around my specimen, so it's hanging there like so. And what the move is you want to suspend it in the water completely but not touching the edges or the bottom. And you want to be able to get a measurement, 1.59. Okay, so once you've weighed up and you've got your dry and your wet measurement, you're going to be able to work out the specific gravity. And the way that you do that is, I'll put up the little sum on the screen, but it is the dry weight, so the amount that the specimen weighed dried, divided by the dry weight minus the wet weight. So I'll put that little calculation up on the screen. I'm gonna put the whole sum down in the description as well, so you're able to come back and look at it whenever you need to. So for mine, the way that I did that, the dry weight was 3.66 grams. So it's 3.66 grams divided by 3.66 grams minus 1.59. So that's got me, my final equation for the specific gravity is going to be 3.66 divided by 2.07, which gives me a specific gravity of 1.77. Now that I know the specific gravity for this individual specimen, the next thing I need to establish is that it's definitely a quartz specimen. So I need to go and look up what the specific gravity of quartz is, so we can try and calculate. Okay, so if we've got the complete volume of this and it was all made out of quartz, what would that weight be? So the specific gravity of quartz is 2.65. So the way we get the differential between the amount of gold and amount of quartz, what we do is we, with that specific gravity of quartz, which is 2.65, and we've got our specific gravity of our specimen, which is 1.77, I'm going to see how much of a percentage this specimen specific gravity is compared to if it was all quartz. So the specific gravity of our specimen is 1.77, so the next move is to work out that percentage is we divide it by the specific gravity of quartz, which is that 2.65. And by working out what that is, that becomes 0.67. So all we have to do is times that by 100, and that will give us our percentage. So it's telling us that the specimen has 67% gold in this. So the gold must go back a little bit, and it's got a decent weight in it. So it seems about right, and there's always going to be a slight variation. So if it's saying 67% gold, I'd be comfortable saying 60 to 70% of this specimen is gold. So if I now think that this is 67% gold and 33% quartz, I'll be able to go back to the original weight and just work out what 67% of the dry weight of this specimen was. So our dry weight was 3.667 grams. So if I work out what 67% of that is, which is you can just times that 3.66 by 0.67, and that will give you an answer. And what that calculates to is 2.45 grams by my calculation. So for out of our 3.6 gram specimen, we've got 2.4 grams worth of gold, which is really, really cool. And it's a simple enough equation. As I said, it's not 100% accurate, but it's just enough to be able to give you a good estimation of the amount of gold in your specimen without having to crush it. Now, if this was ironstone specimen, it'd have a slightly different specific gravity. So instead of using the quartz of 2.65, we'd use a slightly different number, whichever corresponded with the ironstone or whatever host rock that your gold or the mineral that you're trying to weigh up is in. But that's a lot for today, guys. I just thought I'd go through a couple of the basic things to be able to weigh these up, because I find it really handy, and it's able to be able to, as I said, get excited and enjoy how much gold you found without smashing it into a million bits with a little hammer and remembering the specimen that you once had. But all you need is a container of water, a pair of scales, a little bit of string, and then it's just a little bit of mass. So I'll put up all the equations in the description so you can come back and calculate yourself whenever you need to. But thanks again, guys. It's really been appreciated, everybody supporting the channel. I hope this was a little bit helpful and you got something out of it. I'll leave all the details down below so you can calculate it yourself. But have a good week out prospecting, and I'll see you next time. Cheers, guys.